So, Father Time. This is a suggestion for a topic I got on my Facebook page. I'm basically looking for ideas for Narnia topics. I want to make Narnia videos. I really enjoy doing it, but often just don't know where to start because there's so many things I could talk about. And someone suggested Father Time, and I thought that would be a good one because it's very interesting, really weird thing in the books. But it's because he only appears in a couple paragraphs throughout the series. It's not something I would think to make a video about. But when I saw the suggestion, I went, yeah, that is a really interesting topic that might make for an interesting video. So if you have any suggestions for Narnia topics, please either post a comment below or go to my Facebook page. But Father Time, really weird idea. We first see him in the silver chair with Jill Eustace and Puddle Glum. They bring led through Underland by the gnomes to the Lady of the Green Curls' lair. And let's just read Lewis's description from the book.
And here, filling almost the whole length of it, lay an enormous man, fast asleep. He was far bigger than any of the giants, and his face was not like a giant's, but noble and beautiful. His breast rose and fell gently under the snowy beard which covered him to the waist. A pure silver light, no one saw where it came from, rested upon him. That is old Father Time, who was once a king in Overland, said the warden, and now he has sunk down into the deep realm, and lies dreaming of all the things that are done in the upper world. Many sink down, and few return to the sunlit lands. They say he will wake at the end of the world.
So, weird stuff, right? Why the heck is this here? You certainly could remove it from the story, and it wouldn't make any difference. Why the heck is this here? Well, number one, what I think it does for the atmosphere of the story, I think it establishes Underland. To me, is no, this is not just underground. This is not just our world, but it's the underground part of it. No, this is a completely other world. It might as well be another planet. It kind of makes me feel that same sense of awe and wonder I get from Voyage of the Dawn Treaders, sailing into the east. What on earth are they going to find? They could find absolutely anything where different rules apply than the ones we're used to in our world, or even that they know in Narnia. So that's the first thing it does is what the heck else are they going to find down here? To me, it just kind of gives me the shivers. I also think there's just something about, and I think that's the immediate effect it kind of has on the narrative. And I think there's something about the idea of Father Time that kind of rings true for me, that there's a giant sleeping under Narnia that no one knows anything about. But he's patiently waiting for the end of the world. It's coming. It's going to happen. I mean, scientifically speaking, we believe that our world had a beginning and we believe it will have an end. We don't think about it on a daily basis. We go about our lives and we kind of pretend like that's not the case, whether we mean to or not, but it's going to happen. One of these days the sun is going to go out and our world's going to end and we'll just be dust or nothingness or whatever. So I like the idea that there's this ticking time bomb under Father Time bomb, if you will, underneath Narnia that no one knows about. And heck, forget the universe, just your own life, your life and my life. You're gonna die someday. I'm gonna die someday. We kind of pretend we're not going to, I think, because we don't think about it at all. But one day you're not gonna be here. So that's what Father Time does for me personally, for the narrative, and then also kind of upon further reflection what I get out of it. So thanks once again for the suggestion. If you haven't, once again, if you have an idea for a Narnia topic, doesn't matter how big, doesn't matter how small, it can be something super insignificant. It could just be something kind of funny. Doesn't have to be this deep thought-provoking thing, whatever. Post a comment below or go to my Facebook page. I'm really excited to see where this goes.